Hi! One of the main updates of VSDC 6.9 is the ability to fine-tune the movement map from the motion tracking module. The feature is designed to help you make object movement smoother or fix some of the inaccuracies. Let's see how it works. Create a new project and add some footage with a movement object you can track. Click the footage with the right mouse button and select Create Movement Map. Then frame the moving object and hit Start Analysis. When the process is over, hit Apply Editing. Go back to the main timeline tab and add another object you are going to animate. For our example, we're just going to add an ellipse. So double-click the ellipse, open the Add Object menu, proceed to Movement, and select Movement Map. Right mouse click the tracking map and you'll see the new button called Convert to Curve. What you'll get is a pop-up window housing the movement map conversion settings along with the corresponding parameters. Now I'm going to walk you through the parameters one by one and explain what they're here for. For starters, the process of movement map adjustment consists of two steps. During the first step, you optimize the number of tracking points. During the second step, you optimize the curve. Let's start with the former. Create movement map. Essentially, what you need to understand is that the program sees the map as a sequence of points, and the green path is only displayed to make it more convenient for the user. Next step, broken curve. So when you clicked the Convert to Curve button, the program just connected those tracking points, and that's how the curve is drawn. The next step is called tracking inaccuracy. This parameter allows you to ignore some of the tracking points to make the movement path a little smoother. These were the basics, and now let's have a closer look at the curve adjustment process. First step is to switch from a broken curve to Bezier curve. This means that instead of having a plain line connecting the tracking points, we're going to have a smooth spline. And when you use the curve control parameter, you make the path even smoother. It's designed similarly to the tracking inaccuracy parameter. Some of the tracking points around the curve get removed to make it smoother. The curve delta parameter allows you to straighten the curves of the path up to the state of the original tracking map. It helps when there is too much space between tracking points and the object movement doesn't meet your expectations. The area delta parameter works in a very similar way. However, to straighten the curves of the path, the program refers to the area around the curves. Finally, if you apply the max section length parameter to the Bezier curve, the number of tracking points will get optimized based on the maximum possible distance between them. Let's put it all into practice and go back to our graph trying to optimize it. As soon as you hit OK, you'll notice that the tracking map has been converted into the movement map. Meanwhile, the number of tracking points has been reduced, and the timeline now includes keyframes, which you can also work with. If you want some of the parameters to change their values over time, you can achieve that using the initial and final values, or the nonlinear parameter change mode. And this is it for today. We can't wait to hear from you guys. In the comments below, let us know what you think about the new version. Until next time!